presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Let's go to Al in Tampa. Hey, Al, what's going on?
Oh, it's a beautiful thing. I mean, if your listeners don't get the gold report, they're missing out. I mean, with your gold report, you're just printing money. I love it.
You're my best ad out there, Al. Let's go to Jeff in New Jersey. Hey, Jeff, what's going on?
Great. Hey, listen, I was calling to thank you. A few weeks ago, you were prompting on your show to fill out that $10,000 grant.
Yes.
So I filled it out, and just a couple days ago, I found $1,000 in my business checking account.
That's awesome, man. That's awesome. Yeah.
And I owe it to you, because if it wasn't for your prompting, I would have just assumed, you know, no way I would have gotten anything. So I wanted to thank you.
No, we appreciate you growling a problem with us here.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's a TGIF, folks. It's making a great weekend. Accept others the way they are. You cannot change other people. So trying to change them to fit what you want is like trying to change a dog into a cat. A cat into a horse. They are what they are, and you are what you are. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 132, NASDAQ off 28, S&P's down 11, gold contract up $5.80, trading $19.52 an ounce. You got silver up 42 cents, $25.62 an ounce. Light sweet crude down $1.55, $37.23 a barrel, notes and bonds. 10-year note. Down 9 ticks, 138.19. The 30-year bond off 31 or a full point at 32 ticks at 173.12. And King Dollar. King Dollar's down 253 ticks, 92.272. The Euro's at 118. The Yen is at 103.28. And the British Pound is at 131 to 1 U.S. dollar. iPhone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? You got a sideways market out here, folks. We take a look at the SPY. You can have light volume out here today. SPY right now, bingo, trading down 67 cents, sideways market, as I said. Your price spread out here today has been from 350 to 347. You get light volume inside of the SPY. We take a look at the NDX 100. NDX 100, a little bit different. NDX 100 actually tried to get up into these highs of yesterday, and I just couldn't handle it. 29 million shares. That being said, if you do flip any of these onto a weekly chart, folks, bottom line is that you had a week that is pushing into the swing point that was generated out there on the week of the 16th. That's 263 million shares, and you're pushing it to 240. It's not bad. If it was bigger, then you'd say that, okay, bottom line, you can blow that baby away. You know, you're still coming into the downtrend that had 357,000 contracts. We go take a look at the gold contract. Gold contract out here, folks, trading up $6.40. What we did out here yesterday is that you broke the downtrend. Well, the bottom line, gold's been an uptrend for a long period of time. What you did is that the last leg on gold, we went from $1,690 June 5th all the way up to 2089. You came back to the breakout area. You did it with light volume. This is a classic setup, folks, that for markets that want higher price. You ripped apart the downtrend line yesterday. We went from 1902 to 1954. Monster volume behind the move. That's saying that gold's making the move up to 2089, and you very well also may have an ABC structure on the way up on that move. GDX, we got a question on the GDX. Would you hold the GDX? Yeah, definitely hold the GDX. The GDX, folks, bottom line, you're running to these highs of 45.78. You took it apart in spades, and then if you bisect and dissect the equities inside of the GDX, what you're going to see, your top equity is Newmont. Newmont led the charge. You know, Newmont, six trading days ago, was at $58. You're at $68. The high that Newmont's going after is 72.22. And if we turn around, we put this on a weekly, you very well could just blow that baby away. The second highest weighting structure inside of the GDX is Barrick Gold. Barrick just went from a price point of 25 to 28. That also is going after its highs. And then if you start looking at a couple of these streamers, they have it in spades. Franco-Nevada, that's trading 150 right now. 5 days ago, it was at 130. That's going for its all-time highs of 166. And what did pick up also, which is pretty impressive, because this thing's been, you know, a dog, has been Royal Gold. And that's really, you know, not happened with Royal Gold in years. Bottom line is that you came from a high of 147. You made it all the way down to 114. And this is bottom line coming off the bottom, and you have some juice as it's coming off the bottom. And it, what is it going to be all? It's all about the dollar, folks. In fact, I'm going to put the dollar up, DXY. Okay. So what you're going to see here, I'm going to put this on a longer basis, because you'll see if we break this level here, you're going to see that 81 is just sticking out like a sore thumb. 88, rather. 88 was the lows out here established February of 2018. And what you can see is that we made this leg down from 100 all the way down into this 91 area. We've been at this 91 area now, it looks like, about 5 months. That being said, this week, if you talk about taking something south and taking it very quick, this week alone, we went from 94,300 to 92,184. Looks to me it's going to rip it apart. That's going to bring you down to the next level. And if that's what we get, we'll see whether that even holds. Because it held in 2018, and what holds that up was the highs that were generated out here in December of 08, as well as June of 2010. If we go take a look at the opposite correlation of it, meaning the euro, bottom line, had a very slight pullback from the last highs that were out there September 1st, rather. That looks like it's just going to rip those highs apart, meaning the highs of 120. I think 132 is game on the euro. Let me just see this. 125. 125 is game on the euro. And if we go take a look at the British pound, because the pound is the pound, the euro, and the yen are all basically having the dollar go lower. The pound is ready to break topside and get into the 135 price point. And then if we go to the yen looks like it's going to go to par. The stronger that the yen gets, meaning the lower it gets. Oh, this is a decisive break. Look at this. Oh, this is big. 1 second. Oh, let me see this. Oh, yeah. If you're trading metals, folks, hold on for the ride. This is going to be fun. The yen is breaking down, meaning getting so strong. When the yen gets so strong, man, gold just loves going higher. Dow Industrials down 104, NASDAQ off 13, S&P's off 7. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's down 117, Nasdaq's off 21, S&P's are off 9. Let's go take a look at the bonds. So this has been quite a ride inside the bond market, folks. And if we go with the 30 first, what you're going to see is this. So you had a total breakdown. Let's bring this up. And the benchmark that I'm using here, folks, is the lows of the 28th of August. So the low of 28th, that was a spike low inside the 30 as well as the 10. 173.16 is the number. Now, what happened is that we basically approached that level in the beginning of October. The bond saved itself. We came down in the end of October and broke it. It jumped above it again at the end of October. And then on election eve night, that thing went all the way down to 170, closed at 175. Now, that is considered a false break technically. That's how that works. You get a false break technically. Most times when you jump on the other side of that, of whatever false break it is, whether it's a downtown or if it's a false break uptown. So if you're going up and then you break down, bottom line, that normally is where you're going to go. And in this case, we broke down, then we go higher. So that'd be saying that, okay, you're going to go to higher price, lower yield. That being said, however, guess what? You got above it yesterday, closed underneath it. It's light volume today, but now what has happened is that on the weekly basis, bottom line, you are below that level. So if we take a look at this, I'm going to put this on a generic chart now. So this is back to the aspect that it looks to me like you are going to have lower price, higher rates, okay? And what you have here is that, yeah, the 172, well, see, this can pull back to, man, this can pull back to 165. That's the bottom line. If we do the 10-year, we do the same exercise on the 10-year. Let's see, we're going to bring up the generic 10-year. The 10-year's trading 138.18. Did this exact same thing. And inside of the 10-year, next stop would be 137.04. But get in both cases, man, this could pull back right to the breakout area, which is 132. And right now you're at 138. So that lineup there is still lined up, that lower prices and higher rates. You know, and you don't see bonds move that much, folks, but this was a big move, And in fact, as I said, on the weekly basis, still a large move. So the 10-year right now, we are trading out at 0.81. The lows for the last 90 days is 0.53, and the highs are 0.89. You know, so that is one big number. Let's go take a look at Marriott for one of the tigers out here. Marriott came out with their numbers last night. Bottom line, popped it to 250. So the question is, I don't blame him. There's a quote. Man, Tiger Jimmy is saying, I'm in disbelief. I don't blame you, man. So, of course, he's in disbelief, folks, because the fact of the matter is that any hotels or airlines in general having a problem. What this is doing, Jimmy, is that it's coming up to the top of the consolidation, and it can test it. If you get you'd like to get a close today, 102.89 is the number. You know, I don't think you're going to get a close underneath it, but that's the number. Depending on how you're positioned in this, I believe, I'm not sure whether you're in the option market on the short side or just short the stock. Either way, I'd basically put a stop on the other side of, you know, you'd have to put a stop over the, like the 107, 108 area, because it can test that area. But it's, you get a pop, it's on light volume, and I would say this thing wants to pull back into the, you know, 91 area. That's how it looks. Number wise out here, okay, so yeah, you're in good shape. You're shot at almost 103. That you're in good shape, man. Yeah, I'd stay right there, man. I'd stay right there. So, you know, they came out with the numbers, $2.3 billion. They did edge out a 6 cent profit. So, what does happen with the differential with Marriott, folks? As Marriott is a flag carrier, specifically, what that means, they're not building the hotels. They're not paying huge amounts of expenses on the hotels. The individual owners of the hotels would have to do everything. They are a toll gate. It's a toll gate. It's a fee structure. And, you know, when I believe it's Bill Marriott and his brother. I remember this. I'm going all the way back to like 1980. It was his father, I think. Yeah. That's when they changed the business model. And they changed the business model to an aspect that there was a toll deal. And, you know, they're basically a management company. And smart move, huge smart move. Let's go to Apple. So this morning, folks, Apple, someone just laid into Apple right at the open. It's pretty wild. You don't basically see that. Apple, you know, went from 118 to 116.13, and, you know, edged its way all the way back at top side all day long. And that's why you saw the indices themselves edging their way up all day long also. Well, it's going to be interesting to see how we close out here, because what we did get, if we go into the S&Ps and just look at the E-minis, what we got, you know, it was laying up there all day long, no volume whatsoever, and about 10 past 2, I think we got the first sell. Let me just look at this for a second. Whoops. Do it this way. Yeah, so, what's that? Yeah, well, 2:30. 2:30, you got the first little sell down. That being said, let me get this way. I got to get this volume underneath these. Okay, so now we got it. Put that this way. Oh, you can see that volume spike too. Okay, so here's the number you want to keep your eye on. Oh, this is going to be interesting. Okay, so it's 3493. That's where we had volume. We've been testing that area right now. And what it does look like, it looks like we very well could get a rejection of price. But if we don't get, let's see, what time is it? Oh, you get 5 more minutes. No, we don't have anything yet. Interesting. So you got 5 more minutes in this bar. That's the number to watch, folks, because if we close under that bar in the next 10 minutes, next 5 minutes, actually, that sets up a leg down into this 34.81. It's not that much further down, actually. Well, that's 14 points. Then that would put the S&Ps down 23 again. And the S&Ps were fluctuating. You know, they were down 40 last night. They were down 30 at the open. They went actually green. And that's the fluctuation that we have inside of those S&Ps out here today. Dow Industrials, percentage-wise, kind of the same deal. Dow right now is down 92. You get the NASDAQ off 20. S&Ps are off 7.5. Gold's holding. Still, oil. Look at this oil market, man. So oil, down $1.51. I see. Okay, that's not holding price either. Not the end of the world, but $36 coming at you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hanks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market. Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour. Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m. Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m. And Tom O'Brien closes out the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now are down 86. You get the NASDAQ off 17. S&Ps are off 5.5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Dave White, as we do each and every Friday at 30 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Dave has a great show every trading day right here, 2 to 3 Eastern Standard Time. Also, two great newsletters, The Path of Least Resistance, as well as The Tech Insider. Very easy to get either one of those newsletters, folks. Come over to our website at TFNN. You hit newsletters, you'll see the Path of Least Resistance, Tech Insider right there. The Path you can get for 1 month for $119. You can get it for 6 months for $559, which is a savings of $155 or 21%. You can get it for a year, folks, for $985, which is a savings of $443 or 31%. Now, they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. So you'll get it, you like it, you keep it, you don't like it, folks, you can get your money back. Dave White, what's going on?
Well, elections have consequences, and I'm actually looking at the ones that aren't hitting the headlines so much. Everybody else is concerned on a lot of other stuff, but as traders, we kind of have to know at least at some level what kind of legal changes are happening in and around the stocks. The biggest problem, or the biggest, not problem, but the biggest changes in California, they have, of course, the ability to put anything they want and vote on it. And after California lawmakers put some fairly high restrictions on the way that the ride hailing and food delivery services have to had to work, as treating them as full-blown employees. They came out with Proposition 22, which basically said, nah, we're going right back to the way it was. And it passed with about 75% of votes, I think, as of today, anyway, when I looked. So looks like that's going to go and hold. And, of course, Lyft and Uber had big moves.
Oh, yeah. We just had Uber go from 34 folks to 45 in a week, right?
Yep. And it looks like that's actually I was talking earlier with John in the Den on my show, and long-term resistance is about 47. So if it breaks that, that's a fairly long consolidation out of the IPOs. So yeah, you may have a lot.
Uber's, I mean, you get Uber. The difference in Uber, folks, is that you not only have a ride hailing service, you get a food service. And it's a monster. It is a monster. So.
And it could move. And one of the other big things going on in California was, there's two other things. The privacy law passed, and this is actually going to apply to everybody else. Unless Facebook, Google, Spotify, others like that go after it, they may or may not, but it could cost them up to about 15% of earnings on this privacy law, because it would be a always opt out kind of system where you now have to opt out of stuff. You'd have to opt in on this new privacy law.
Right.
And so we've been kind of talking about this maybe for 2 years.
I know.
And this,
so what Dave is saying, folks, is that when we get on these things now, if you don't want the thing, you got to opt out. If you want in, they got to tell you, number one, how much they're going to track you. And then you're saying, okay, I want to be tracked. I'll opt in. So, yeah.
So we could see some, they've kind of looked weak to me for a little while anyway, but you could see, earnings maybe weak next year as everybody figures out what they can and can't get away with. But right now the legal arguments are this does not actually apply to anybody outside of California. That's, of course, the position of Facebook, Google, and others.
Sure.
Of course, the California folks are saying it does apply to literally everybody around the world. So we'll see, but my guess is that would head to court. And generally, the way that those have been settled in the past is if it applies to a California citizen, it applies to the rest of the United States too. So I don't. Maybe they can put it off for a while, but it does look like that would be part of it. One other thing that I don't have a slide for was that they passed a provision for $5 billion for stem cell research. And other than the fact that California's broke, I don't know where they're going to find the $5 billion for it.
California's broke? California's one of the richest states in the whole world. Never mind our country.
No, I meant the government. They don't have, they're way in debt, kind of like the United
California
States.
California is the fifth largest economy in the world, Dave.
Right, but they're spending a lot more than they have.
Go ahead.
If you look deep into it, they've got financial.
Anyway, go ahead, man.
So, like I said, but anyway, maybe some of those biotech stocks can get back in there. Everybody's kind of, we talked about the CRISPRs being kind of hot. But $5 billion is enough to get a lot of people going in maybe some stem cell research if that money ever comes up. But you never know. Anyway, that's the first part of it. Let me find my other slide here. One of the other big things going on was in Massachusetts, the right to repair. And that is on where we've talked about it on cell phones and other things. This is on cars.
Yes. So
beginning in 2022, all manufacturers who wish to sell vehicles in Massachusetts must equip those vehicles with an open access data platform. And, you know, if right now, if you went to buy tools to find out what's wrong with your car, they can be extremely expensive. Those folks that make them, that it aren't the OEMs, have to de-engineer them and make them. This would mean that with a phone and Bluetooth, you should be able to investigate just about everything in the car that the dealer could do with their very expensive equipment. So I don't know if this is going to actually move to other states, but the biggest company involved may become an IPO over the next couple of years on this. It's called iFixit.
Okay.
They sell all kinds of kits, and they have videos on their website to take apart phones, repair them, screens, batteries, swaps, a lot of stuff you'd have to spend a lot of money for. Apple products to all the rest.
Right. So what Dave's talking about here, folks, this is important because in the context, so all the dealers, like if you get a, car, you bring it to the dealer. They just put up, because cars are all computers now, right? So the car companies, don't even want to let any other fixing people have those computers. That's what this battle's about.
And of course, even if you don't want to fix it yourself, you want to go to a local mechanic.
Exactly.
Can he spend $5,000 for this device that probably would sell for $250 if it was mass market? And that's exactly what this is. So this is the first part of that. As we move more to electric cars, my thought is we'll be more on hydrogen than we will on batteries. This actually becomes probably a little less important, but things will always break. But I bought the iFixit kits, and you know, if you want to fix your cell phone, you know, you can buy most of everything you need for $25. And a little kit from those guys. So they're really excited about this and they're going to start making kits for cars. If you do it in Massachusetts, you're probably going to have to do it across the United States. So there may be a lot more to you fix it home shape free mechanics coming back who haven't been able to work on their cars for a number of years.
Stay right there, folks. Dave and I come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Directions Daily S&P Biotech 3x Bull and Bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now down 12. You get the NASDAQ up 7, S&P's up 2.5. We're talking with our man, Mr. Dave White. We are talking technology.
Back in, I think it was 2015, one of the big arrests of the Silk Road dark website got arrested. At the time, he had a ton of Bitcoins.
Okay.
And he never would cough up the key for those. Well, we on Monday, about $1 billion came out of Bitcoin, $1 billion, and no one knew what happened. Well, a couple on Wednesday kind of found out that the guy that ran the Silk Road had this one wallet, but eventually the U.S. government was able to actually crack the key and get all the cash out of it. And on 2015, it was worth about $100 million. But of course, this week, about $1 billion worth.
Yeah, because those twins, Winklevoss twins, they're billionaires again. Yeah, right.
Yeah, yeah. Now you got me going with the
pronunciation. I know, man.
Yeah.
Sorry.
So there's two things I think a little bit about that. Everybody was talking earlier about maybe a better voting model would be blockchain voting. And like I said, tells you that if they want to crack it, they can crack it. I think a lot of people think that just about anything they do electronically would be safer. And the answer is, for a lot of reasons, blockchain voting wouldn't work. One, probably too slow. And there's a lot of reasons for that. But also the ability, I think a lot of people think that whatever they have in their Bitcoin wallets is uncrackable. Well, it isn't. And yeah, given enough money and interest in it, people will come out and be able to absolutely crack the keys, even for something as hard to crack as Bitcoin. So now that we know that it can be cracked, I think a lot more people will probably be looking at finding the ways that it was cracked by the government and duplicating it. If one person could do it, everybody can.
Yeah. Hey, but listen to this. Don't mean to interrupt you, but this is going to be a monster. So Biogen just got halted. Now, Biogen, folks, on Thursday went from a price point of 251 to 363 on the aspect that this drug is going to be cool. And guess what? Bottom line, the FDA said, hey, guess what? You failed to show that this drug has any effectiveness for Alzheimer's disease.
Yeah, it was going to be the first new drug in 30 years.
Yeah,
for Alzheimer's. So there isn't anything else out there.
Right.
If it had any kind of help,
I feel for anyone that owns it. That's going to open down $100 probably. Wow, intense.
Are you seeing any indication?
No, it's not going to. I'd say what normally happens when it's this late in the day and they halt.
Yeah, they're just going to. That's what I was going to say.
They won't open it. Yeah,
until Monday.
They won't open.
So that was supposed to be a huge drug for them. And like I said, there hasn't been anything for 30 years. But a lot of new new research just in the last couple of years. So there may be other ways of skinning that cat.
Yeah.
But it's all kind of calcification of the neurons. So I think everybody kind of – in fact, they really just figured out what caused it in the last year. So not uncommon that they're still looking for a better way to go after that.
Pretty intense, no doubt.
But, you know, it's biotechs, heaven and hell,
yeah,
right?
Right.
But that's one of the reasons why you probably on biotechs are, even though they're expensive options, aren't always that expensive.
No, not when you have, that's why they're expensive. The, you know,
yeah.
Either
but
way they're going to go.
A lot cheaper than the alternative today.
Seriously, man, seriously.
What did I didn't look at it real quick. Let me find it here. But I was going to say, what does the IBB look like?
Oh, that's – see, that this is cool what Dave's saying, folks, okay? Because, see, that's still tradable, and that should have dove. Yeah, it did. It did. Okay, so it's not as much as it could, though. No, it actually did, okay? That went, so with that news, it went from 139 to 137. That's not that much, really, man. I mean, there's no
reason.
Yeah,
it was like – I don't know if it's as bad as everybody thought, because what the IBB just a few days ago is like 145 or something, and people have been selling it off kind of over the last couple of days. So I was always wondering whether or not it was going to be that good.
Yeah, see, it's interesting. So the Biogen is only 4.5% of that.
In fact, most people don't know. What's the other one for biotech?
Amgen?
No, the ETF.
I'm not
thinking
sure.
About XLB or something. What is it?
XLB.
Maybe somebody in the den can say. The reason I'm saying on that one is that the IBB has almost 200 stocks in it.
Yeah.
So you get – I tend to play that one a lot more than the other one. And I want to say, is it XLB?
I just pulled it. Wait, that's materials.
No, that's not it. Anybody in the den? Ah, it's driving me nuts. L – what is it? L –
Well, that's a direction one. That's 300%.
No. It's
Lab, LAB?
LABD, yeah. LABD. This one is very, very tight, kind of like the NASDAQ, and a few of those can really move it.
Oh, yeah, but that's the direction. That's what I was saying. That's the direction 300%.
Yeah, no, but there's another one, too.
Yeah.
I'll think of it. But... Well, I'm kind of surprised, like you said, but it's been kind of going down for a while. I mean, the IBB kind of spiked. And
yes.
That was last Friday. They were actually saying this was a shoe-in. So.
Oh, I know. And this is the second time this has happened, folks. Okay. If you look at the IBB, I think it's 2 or 3 years ago. It got smoked. I mean, because the exact same thing. The last time this happened, it wasn't the FDA, it was Biogen themselves came out and said this drug doesn't work. And then all of a sudden they revived it again.
Yeah. And they do that a lot.
Yeah.
There's out of probably 50 drugs that get started, maybe one actually becomes a hit. So it's not one of those things where everything is always a big winner. And generally, I don't know on this particular one, generally these drugs come out of smaller companies.
Yes.
And, you know, it's kind of the equivalent of the investigative gold stocks where they're just, you know, looking for gold. They're not, like we talked last week, not really going to build anything themselves.
Right.
So they'll get started on a drug and then somebody bigger will buy them out. And I think that's exactly what happened on this one, but last time I read about this was 2 weeks ago.
Yeah. Stay right there, folks. Dave and I are going to be coming right back. We got the Dow turning. They're all turning green right now. You get the Dow up 37 points. You got the NASDAQ up 25. S&Ps are up by 9.5. Gold's up 590. Oil going the other way. Oil looks like we're at 37.34. That wants to go down to that 36 level. Dave and I come right back, folks. We'll be right back.
back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and to help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, an essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy to use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's flat, Nasdaq up 17, S&P's up 5.5, and bottom line, folks, you get a sideways market out here with no volume, by the way. So,
well,
taking a little break from yesterday.
Yeah, we got the answer in the den. I couldn't think of it. It's the XBI,
okay,
which is the other ETF. But it's got most of the weighting in about 30 stocks. It has a whole lot less, like about a third. And if you look at the chart on that in the late part of 2 o'clock hour, you'll see the dip.
Yes.
So that one's even much more a mover than the, as I said, than the IBB, mostly because the IBB has 190 or 195 stocks in it. So it doesn't move as much as you would think. Some of the other ETFs for biotech really have the move.
Yeah, these are the smaller biotechs or something.
Yeah.
Amgen's not even in it. And Biogen, I don't think, is either. So maybe they're probably exploration ones, just like we were talking about that.
Anyway, the last thing for this week I was going to talk about is they've actually come up with the first room temperature superconductor. It's not anything that will ever hit the streets, but they've gotten one to work at 58 degrees, where most of these things have to be cooled to almost absolute zero.
Okay.
To get anything going. The downside is this has got the equivalent of a couple of houses on the size of a something that's the head of a pin. At that kind of this is kind of the first breakthrough of any kind of a room temperature semiconductor. Everything from electric cars to motors to electronics. If they ever get this, this is the holy grail of the next materials inventions.
There we go. Thanks, Dave. Have a great weekend. Safe weekend. Look forward to the show next week. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows. Have a great weekend. Have a safe weekend, folks. Come back and visit us Monday morning. Tommy kicks us off 8:30 in the morning. Great show. Bam! Go get him, folks.